Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Tiffany, and today's video is going to be a tutorial slash first impressions. So I was on Twitter and I came across this brand. The owner is super sweet. I came across this brand. I'm pretty sure it's called Bella and Company, not Bella and Co. It says Bella and Co, but I'm pretty sure the CEO stands for company. So Bella and Company, and I decided to order eyeshadow palette. They were having a sale. You buy the eyeshadow palette, get 2 glitters for free. So I did go ahead and pick up the palette. The palette is called Bella Primavera, and this is the actual packaging of the palette. And the part that came over top of like the whole actual palette was this design too, I'm pretty sure, but I threw it in the trash. And this is the actual palette. So it is super colorful, super spring appropriate. I know that we're on lockdown, so like you're like, sis, what are you worried about spring for? But like, it's still spring regardless, so I thought it was cute. And I bought 2 glitters, and I got 2 glitters for free because of the palette. So I don't remember which ones I actually bought and which ones I got for free, but these are all the glitters I got. I'm not sure which ones I'm going to use today, but I'm excited to play in them because I have been more into glitter as of late. So literally, I was going to come in here and just do the eyes, but I was like, psych, you know you don't do that. So I'm going to do a full face, probably super glam because it's super colorful, super in your face, and I'm not trying to come here with a natural beat with colorful eyes. That's not she, me, her. So that's what we're gonna be doing today. If you're not already subscribed to my channel though, before we even jump to the video, then make sure you do that, because if you're not already subscribed, then you're missing out. And if you guys are excited to see what look I come up with this beautiful palette and some glitter, then just stay tuned. Okay, so my brows are on. They're looking hella fire today. I did my hair, guys. I dyed my hair. As you can see, my roots are super light. My hair is completely blonde. It's like a blondish, yellowish vibe. Like, it's blonde and kind of yellow. It's kind of like, I don't know how to describe what the color is, to be completely honest. I will insert a picture somewhere on screen of how my hair actually looks like, what color my hair actually is right now, because you guys can kind of see. Like, my roots are blonde, but like my hair is whatever, you can see it. It doesn't matter. It's not important. But I did want to come on here and do my first eye with you guys, and then I'll do my other eye off camera most likely, so you guys can see like my first impressions or whatever. I'm also trying out this CoverGirl True Blend Concealer. I got the shade Caramel T700. People have been raving about this concealer, and I wanted to try it. So I'm going to try it for everything today, for priming my eyelid, for under eye concealer, for everything, because I'm trying to see, you know, what's tea. I'm trying to see what's good with this concealer. So this is how I'm going to test it out, because I know I use concealer as eyeshadow primer. It's rare that I use eyeshadow primer, so this... So this is me testing it out all around. This color though is pretty freaking perfect. And I picked this out without actually swatching or anything in Walmart, because I know Walmart, they be tripping. Like, a lot of stuff being plastic and all that, and I don't got time. So I don't know what look I wanna do. What glitters do I have? I think I'm gonna do something with pink and purple, and then I'm gonna throw a little razzle dazzle and add this green and blue glitter. That's what I think I'm going to do. This isn't even creased on my eye, and y'all know my eye is creasy. She's creasy. I'm gonna go ahead and use this color right here. That's the color Daylily. Is that what it's called? Sure, that's what I think it's called. And I'm gonna pack that on the outer part of my eye. Oh wow. And I'm gonna drag it a little bit in my crease. This is really pretty. I'm kind of trying to decide. Let me turn this way so you guys can actually see what's going on. I'm trying to decide if I want to blow out the eyeshadow and like drag it out, but I don't know. This is super pretty though. Wow, really pretty. Another thing to note is that it's not a lot of kickback in the pan, and I'm pretty aggressive when I'm actually doing my eyeshadow and like dipping it inside the palette, but it is not a lot of kickback at all. I mean, I wouldn't care. I would just literally scoop the kickback off the palette, but that's just something to note. That is really good. Normally colorful shadows, like a lot of them can be powdery, but so far this is not. Should I go into Tulip? Yeah, I'm gonna go into Tulip, and that's this pink shade right here. What brush am I gonna use? Okay, I'm gonna use this brush. It's kind of fluffy, just like a smidge, and I'm just going to pack that on the outer corner of this. Ooh, look at that. Oh my goodness, that looks so good. This pink has a little bit more kickback than the purple, but it's like nothing serious, so like nothing to call home about. But wow, the pigment on these shadows and this concealer, everything is blending really good over top of it. Like nothing's getting caught on. You know, sometimes you use concealer and the shadows start to like stick to the concealer. That's not happening. I wanted to use this brush so I can like brush out the edges, outer perimeter of the shadow, like into my brow. Like, look at that's a fucking blend.
Can you put this, like,
that is really freaking pretty. Okay, I'm gonna go cut my crease off camera with some glitter glue, and then I'm going to return. This looks so good. Like, and it's not irritating on the eye. It's definitely a chunky glitter, like it's little hexagons or whatever, but this does not irritate my eye or nothing. It doesn't feel heavy or anything, but it looks so freaking cute. Like, I'm shook. Okay, the glitter I used is called Decadence Weekend, and it's literally like big and small little hexagon shapes or whatever. So I'm going to go ahead and put a little bit of NYX glitter primer on this little cap that I have for my eye makeup remover, because I did go ahead and remove the makeup that was on my lid prior to me actually cutting my crease with the glitter primer. This is actually what the glitter looks like. If you guys can see, please don't fall. So I'm going to use a brush, and I'm literally gonna, whatever just fell on my table, I'm gonna pick it up with this brush because I don't want to waste any of it. This is so ghetto. And I'm gonna go ahead and pack it on. This is so freaking pretty. Like, who is she? She's using glitter. I'm gagging. This looks so good. Like, I wish prom didn't get canceled, because I would be killing the game on my clients with this glitter. These are so freaking pretty. Oh my goodness. Okay, so before I go off camera and do my lashes, I want to put on the screen, probably a split screen, the different other glitters that I got. So I will tell you guys the name, probably put the name under the picture too. But the first one I got is Mardi Gras Mambo, and it's a blue and green. I think they're little hexagons too. Yeah, they're little hexagons too. So basically the same one as Decadence. What is this called? Decadence Weekend that I have on my eyes right now, just in blue and in green. And then I got Storyland, and it's literally different colors. It's like purple, green, blue. They're like iridescent or whatever. Super cute. And then the last one I got is Second Line, and it's literally just like an iridescent blue, and it's so freaking pretty. But I'm gonna go do my lashes off camera, and then we return so we can do the face and get beat. This looks freaking phenomenal, and I'm kind of shaken to my core. Phenomenal. Okay, so I'm going to be using two primers today. I'm going to use No Problem Prime Essence from Touch and Soul. And I'm just going to put it right here. This feels so good on my face. Is this editorial? She's looking glowy. Then I'm going to use the Touch and Soul No Pore Blum Actual Primer. And I'm just going to... I just squirted out real aggressive. I'm just going to use it right in this area around my nose. And then, like, right up under my eye. Okay, well, it's not right up under my eye, but, like, it's right up under my eye. Like, it's not, like, right in the little crevice, but it's there. So, I'm going to use the Too Faced, I'm about to say Born This Way, the Hangover RX Primer. This looks so washed out. Do you guys like my new backdrop? I didn't say anything about it, but, like, do you guys love it? Do you love it? It's fabric from Walmart. So, if you notice, these fingers are... my nails are cut because I had to do my hair and my nails are super long and I had to do what I had to do. Like, this is how people actually do like hair. I don't do hair. I make wigs. I don't do hair. But this is how people who actually do hair, a lot of times they have these two nails cut short so they can grip like braiders and all that. But it needed to be done because I need to do my hair. So I'm going to use the Urban Decay Stay Naked Foundation. And I have the shade 70. Okay, square it out. Warm yellow. And this is like 2 full pumps. Because I literally pushed the thing halfway down for both times. Here we are. And this is my Real Techniques sponge. I haven't used this sponge for like foundation in so long. But it's still a staple. Like, it's a good sponge. Look at this color. Look at this coverage. Look at my shoulder. Look at me. This is it. I'm feeling myself with this glitter, y'all. I'm feeling myself with this glitter. Another video was supposed to go up before this tutorial, but I think I might just download this, edit it, and then put it up tomorrow. I think I might because I'm dying here. I'm gagging at myself. I am flawless. I'm going to be using the CoverGirl True Blend Concealer. Obviously, I said that when I used to prime my eye. It's the True Blend Undercover Concealer. I got the shade T700 Caramel. This is the same color I used to prime my eye. If I like it, I will get multiple colors. This color is perfect for me. Look at me matching myself in the Walmart. Do y'all know how hard it is to match yourself somewhere where they don't have testers? Like, it's literally the same as if you were matching yourself online, which I hate doing. So if I haven't tried something before, 9 times out of 10, I won't buy it online because I don't know what color I'm gonna need. So why would I buy it online if I don't know what color I'm gonna need? I don't set myself up for failure. Like, who do I look like? This is so pretty. Wow, this concealer is really pretty. Okay, let me blend my nose out before I blend out my under eye. I'm kind of shook. Like, I kind of want to let it dry down a little bit more before I blend it out because I'm curious to see what's really gonna happen. But like, since I'm not, what's I about to say? I'm so discombobulated. Since I'm not cream contouring today, it's really no reason for me to let it dry down. So I guess I'm not gonna let it dry down too much. But I don't know why when I like something, I sit up so goddamn close to this camera. Like, I had a glitter piece under my eye, so I was doing damage control. That looks so good. Wow. This looks freaking good. Oh my goodness. I'm kind of shook by it. Like, wow. Okay, she coming for L'Oreal's neck. Okay, I'll see you. Okay, so I'm going to do something I rarely do. Actually, I never do because y'all never see me use this. I'm going to use a Too Faced Born This Way setting powder. I'm about to say the whole name. It's called Ethereal Setting Powder. That's mad long. This is in Translucent Medium. I literally don't ever use this. Like, I can't tell you the last time I did, but I'm going to do it today because I'm really trying to get through the stuff that I have in my drawers before I purchase like anything OD new. Oh wait, that looks kind of good. Hold on. I've been sleeping on this powder. This looks good. I look so smooth. did I fail myself? Okay, I think I might have. I'm gonna use my Fenty Beauty bronzer in Coco Anati. Am I out of focus? I'm in focus now. I don't know if I was out of focus at first. I can't even tell you. I don't even want to lie because I have no freaking idea if I was out of focus. But I'm gonna use this, and I'm gonna use this little angled brush I got from TJ Maxx like a year and a half ago, 2 years ago, probably at this point. Huh? This looks so good. Where's my nose brush? I'm gonna use this to contour my nose too. I'm not gonna go all the way down because I don't need nothing flapping back and trying to clock me at all. I'm gonna go ahead and add some blush, my Alamar Cosmetics blush. I have purple on my eyes. I'm gonna use this shade in the middle so everything is cohesive. I'm gonna use that same brush I used to add bronzer and pop that on my cheeks. That is a lot of blush. Yes, the hell it is. Okay. Oh my goodness. I just knocked something out. Oops. I'm going to spray my face with this Maybelline, what is this? Maybelline Last and Fix Makeup Setting Spray up to 16 hour wear matte finish. Oh, matte finish. I know I love makeup. Let me spray myself. So for highlighter, I'm going to use this Dose of Colors and Desi and Katie Fuego highlighter. And I feel like I've been using this a lot lately, but I really like it. So that's why. And I'm going to just put a little bit on my cheeks while my face is still drying down a little bit. Just to add a little bit of sheen. That looks great. I'm definitely putting some on my nose. Do you need this? No. Do some people think it's overrated? Yes. Do I? No. Do I care what they think? No. I'm a clown, bro. So I'm gonna just dab all this in. Oh, wow. Normally after I spray my face, I look not dewy, but like, still like I got a little bit of glisten or something. This is definitely a matte spray. Wow. Oh wow. I like it. This is my first time using this. I really like this. I really, 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 really like this. Okay, so I'm going to use this Maybelline 650 Nude Embrace Lipstick. It's obviously a nude, just like I just fucking said. Don't want to use a pink? No, I'm not. I'm going to go the opposite direction to what I want to do. I want to do a pink or a purple, but I'm not going to do that. This doesn't look bad without a liner because I didn't line, like I didn't put it all over my whole lip. But I'm still gonna use a liner because I always use liners. So I'm gonna use this NYX liner in the shade, damn, that's broke, Espresso. And this isn't a matte lipstick, so I don't need to put a gloss over top of it. It's more of a cream lipstick. So this is the final look. The big reveal before I scoot back, you know, serve some looks, some angles, some all of that. So let me go ahead and do it now. You guys already saw the finished look and y'all cannot tell me this does not look fire. Bro, this looks so freaking phenomenal. Like, I think phenomenal might be my word of the month, but I am loving my skin right now. Like, I just burped a little bit, my bad, but I'm loving my skin right now. I'm loving this lip with this eye. I'm loving this glitter. Ah! I love everything about this right now. I'm so happy. I want to cry, But I'm even loving my hair. I was a little skeptical about having the light roots with my hair, like with the dark, well, not dark brown, but like the brown, like the darker blonde. But I'm feeling it. Like, I'm feeling like a whole vibe, a whole mood right now. Anyway, if you have not tried anything from Bella and Company, I will leave the link down below in the description box so you can go ahead and do that. If you didn't subscribe in the beginning of the video, then you're phony. Go ahead and do that right now. Give this video a thumbs up if you have not already, because I think I served a look or two today. But that's all I have for this video today. So like I always tell you guys, I'm your girl Tiffany. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.